Whether you use Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge or even Firefox or another browser, there is one setting that you should probably disable that drastically improves your protection against so-called zero-day vulnerabilities, which are exploits that hackers find before the developers do, meaning they can use them in cyber attacks before there's even a patch available. So what is this setting? Well, depending on your browser, it's going to be called something different, but in Chrome, for example, it's called Don't Allow Sites to Use JavaScript Optimization. But hold on, because before you just go and change it, and before I explain where to find this in other browsers too, understand that there are some potential trade-offs, and you should never just go and blindly change a setting just because some tutorial says to anyway. So at least hear my explanation for what this setting actually does, and why I do think it is well worth the trade-off, but you still should know what to expect. I'll try to keep this explanation as quick and simple as possible, but basically, every website these days is not just static content. They use a lot of JavaScript code to make dynamic stuff that changes depending on what you're doing. And in the never-ending quest of making websites load faster, browsers do something called compilation of the JavaScript code, which you can basically think of like translating the code into machine code that the computer can read faster. This is called just-in-time compilation because it happens just before it runs, and it does actually make JavaScript faster. However, this extra processing step adds a lot of complexity, and with additional complexity comes more room for mistakes and bugs. And therein lies the problem. A few years ago, Mozilla did an analysis of different exploits that had happened recently at the time, and they found that around half of all the exploits in Google Chrome in the years prior were related directly to just-in-time compilation. But it was much more than half if you looked at the exploits that were zero-day vulnerabilities, meaning they were actively exploited, as you can see in this chart. But this pattern was not just for Google Chrome, it was for all browsers, as you can see. And that is what this setting is for. And to be clear, this does not disable JavaScript. It simply disables the steps that speed it up extra. And as a result, the next time an inevitable exploit happens in this just-in-time compilation stuff, then you'll be protected even before it's ever patched. As a matter of fact, just earlier this month, there was a zero-day exploit in the compilation algorithm. Now, an important caveat, technically in Google Chrome, this setting does not actually fully disable just-in-time compilation in its entirety, rather just what they call optimizations within it. That being said, in one bug discussion thread that I was reading, a Google developer said that disabling this optimization setting is probably about the same in terms of security to disabling compilation altogether, and you can read their full comment here if you want. Though I will point out, Microsoft Edge specifically does have a setting that does let you fully disable just-in-time compilation, and Google Chrome actually, technically you can, it's just a bit of extra work. I'll get to all that later. Anyway, the trade-off to disabling the optimizations or just-in-time compilation entirely obviously is that JavaScript is not going to run as fast, strictly speaking. But computers these days are so much faster anyway than when this was created initially that you are almost certainly not even going to notice a difference at all. I mean, we're talking milliseconds here usually. And if there is some site that you do notice drastically slows down for some reason, then you can simply add it as an exception and then it'll be able to run again. And interestingly, in a blog post where Microsoft talked about all this, they found that there was basically no difference overall in average if you disable the just-in-time compilation, and apparently sometimes there's actually an improvement, because I guess the compilation would actually take longer than certain basic code. So again, you're probably not going to notice a difference. So next, I can go over where to find these different settings in the various browsers, because some of them do have special steps you need to do. Before I get to that though, something else that you should be securing is all your personal information online, which is where today's sponsor comes in, DeleteMe, a data privacy service to which I myself have been a paying customer for over 4 years now, from before they ever even sponsored. If you've ever Googled yourself, you definitely have seen the countless data broker websites who not only collect and display all your personal information, like name, address, and phone number, but then also sell it to companies and other sketchy people to do whatever they want with it. This also makes it easier for malicious people to find and use your own info against you in phishing attacks, identity theft, harassment, and more. But that's where DeleteMe comes in. They do all the work for you in submitting removal requests on your behalf. As new data brokers pop up, they're constantly adding new ones that they remove from, and when you sign up, you get a privacy report showing exactly which sites you were removed from after 7 days and every 3 months after that. You can even submit custom requests to remove your data from hundreds of other sites, and an expert will handle that for you. This includes some even surprising sites like berkeley.edu and certain government sites, so not just purely data brokers. Plus, they have other useful privacy tools like email masking and phone number masking for US users. So if you want to get your personal information removed from the web and search results, go to joindeleteme.com/Theojo or scan the QR code and use the promo code Theojo for 20% off all consumer plans. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so for finding the setting, let's start out with the Chromium-based browsers. So specifically, that's gonna be Google Chrome, Brave Browser, Opera, and Vivaldi. I'll do Edge next, that's actually different. For all of these, a common way to just get to the settings menu is to type in the URL bar about:settings, and that will work for all of them because again, these are all based on the same Chromium-based browser. And therefore, on the left side, all of them should have a setting, privacy and security. The themes might look different, but it should be still there. And then in that, go to security. And then you're gonna wanna look for the thing that says either manage JavaScript optimization and security, or in Opera, it might just be called manage V8 security. V8 is the name of the JavaScript engine. Then in the next menu, that's where you would choose don't allow sites to use JavaScript optimization, or again, it might say V8 optimizer instead, but it's the same thing. You might also be able to get to this menu just by going to this URL directly though. You'll find that in that same menu page, you'll also be able to add exceptions like I mentioned. And by the way, if you wanna use wildcards for like a subdomain, you have to use this syntax with the brackets. It won't let you do it if you don't have those. Now, if you want to disable the compilation completely, not just the optimizations, you can do it for these browsers. And to do that, you would have to use the launch argument that I'll put on the screen here. That's a bit more advanced though. You would have to create a shortcut in Windows or whatever and add that to the end of the target box. And that also means that you would have to remember to use that shortcut to launch the browser every time you do. It's not like it changes it and then is remembered. As for the mobile versions of these browsers, on Android at least, it seems that you can usually find kind of the same setting name in the same location, like in privacy and security, then JavaScript optimization and security or something similar. And then on iOS, at least for Google Chrome, the equivalent feature setting is called lockdown mode, which is not actually related to Apple's lockdown mode, but it does appear to block JavaScript compilation. For other browsers though, on iOS specifically besides Chrome, it seems like they don't really have this option possibly, at least on Brave they didn't. So that's unfortunate. All right, next up, here's how to do it on Microsoft Edge. So you're gonna wanna go to the settings, then privacy, search and services, and then go to the security menu. You could also just go to this path directly. Then once you're in this menu, look for and enable the option called enhance your security on the web, and then select either balanced or strict. Even though it says balanced is recommended, I personally would set it to strict. If you do happen to notice that a lot of sites that you use start to break or act weird, you can always set it to balanced, or it's really easy to add an exception by just clicking the lock next to the URL and then clicking this enhanced security thing and then just toggling it off for that site. You can also add exceptions through the settings menu too. I will point out though that the enhanced security mode in Microsoft Edge does a lot more than just the optimization setting that the other Chrome browsers do. As you can see in the info box, it says that it completely disables JavaScript just-in-time compilation, not just the optimization parts, and it also enables other security protections that the other one doesn't. Now, as for the mobile versions of Microsoft Edge, for both Android and iOS, surprisingly, there does not seem to be an option to use this enhanced security mode. I don't know why that is. Now for Firefox, unfortunately, it's not just one easy setting. There's actually several different flags you have to set. So you can get to those by going to about config in the URL bar. And while I couldn't find an official list, there was one Reddit user who seems to listed all of them out. So basically you would search one by one for all of these in the flags menu. They should all be Boolean types that you set to false to disable it. And I'll put them all in the description so you can just copy and paste. Do note that for some of these, the flag might not actually exist. For example, this trusted principles one. And if that's the case, you need to click the plus button on the right, which will create it. And then you also have to double click it to change it to false. So just do that for any of them that show a plus sign that means you have to create it. Again, be aware that this is not an official list. It's possible that it's overkill. So I would probably suggest submitting a feature request to Mozilla, and hopefully they'll add an easier setting that is just one toggle. As for the mobile version of Firefox, like on Android and iOS, apparently the mobile versions do not have access to the About config menu, so I don't think there's a way to disable it with Firefox on mobile. For a Safari browser, whether you're on iPhone or iPad or macOS, the only way, unfortunately, to disable the just-in-time compilation is to enable lockdown mode on your entire device. Of course, Apple being Apple, they do not seem to offer a way to disable the compilation just by itself. And unfortunately, lockdown mode is probably way overkill and not worth it just to do that, because it disables a ton of other features as well. I'd like to hear what you guys think though, if you're gonna change this setting now that you know about it. We can talk about all that down in the comments. Thanks again to DeleteMe for sponsoring. And again, if you wanna have your personal info removed from data brokers, go to joindeleteme.com/Theojo and use the promo code Theojo for a discount. Now, another related video I made you might wanna watch is where I talked about a bunch of different browser security settings that you might wanna change. So kinda related, but more of them. I'll put that link right there you can click on. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. And if you want to hit the like button, I'd appreciate it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.